Hey, what's going on everybody? This is Paulio Jr. and in this video I'm going to do a review of the program called MacX DVD Ripper Pro for Windows. And this is actually a company that I believe I've come across in the past. It's called Digiarty, if that's how you pronounce it. And with most of their products, they actually deal mostly with anything Apple related, Apple and Mac related. So, but they do have a couple of programs that are able to install onto a Windows operating system. And the review that I wanted to do today was with the MacX DVD Ripper Pro, which is typically $60 as of today, which is July 8th. They have it on sale for about $40, and you can actually do the free trial download. Now, I do have the full version, and I will say that it is definitely the most, as far as what I've come across, the most simplistic and efficient DVD ripper that I've actually come across, and that's a completely unbiased opinion. It's just a fact. So this is where you would go to download it, and it actually brings you to this site. If you go to this actual page right here, the MacDVD.com/Mac, blah blah blah, and you go there, and if you click the free trial download or the full version, those are going to bring you to where you can download it for your Apple, for your Mac. But if you have Windows, you would just click up here with the Windows version, click here, and then it'll bring you to here where you can download the Windows version, and it's the same thing. You can buy it or you can do the free trial. I'm not exactly sure how long or what limitations you have with the free trial, but with the full version, this is definitely probably one of the best softwares that I've come across in a little bit. So we're going to go through it. Long story short, download the free version, check out the trial version, and I'm going to go directly into the full version. So let's go right into it. MacX DVD Ripper Pro for Windows. And basically what this program offers you when you initially start it up is an extremely simple user-friendly interface, and you basically have all of your options are right in front of your face. They're nice, big, and bold, and there's really not a lot of things that would get complicated in this process. It's a very simple process on what you want to do, and it even shows you right here getting started, and going from there. A lot of things you can do with this. I actually was playing around with it a lot today, and the one thing that I did like, and is the, because a lot, I know a lot of people do download from the internet, but there are still people that have DVDs and so forth. But regardless, what this offers you, so what I actually did was I had the DVD Wedding Crashers, and so what this is going to do is offer me the opportunity to bring everything I want, or just the movie itself, to my computer in basically any format that I desire. They have just a plethora of options on the video outputs that you can use for this. So we're going to click disc. There's nothing in there. I'm going to pop this guy in real quick, and then it should come up as the Wedding Crashers, and that's your source. So this is the first thing that you can do with it, the first option you can do with it. So as soon as that comes up, there it is, Wedding Crashers. Close that out, hit OK, and then it's going to load all the titles and so forth, but it's really oriented to just the movie that is on the disc, and you can check off the other things that you want on in this little in these columns right here, in these rows right here, you can check off the different titles if you really do want them to be in your as your output video. You can do it as a DVD backup, and like I said, you can pick your device as well, which is really, really cool. So it's actually very precise to the device in which you're using. And if your device isn't available on here, even if you just do the general, because for instance, I have the Moto G, the Android Moto G, and I just did I did the general Android mobile, and even at where you get to pick the low quality and the high quality, and then the normal quality, even the low quality that I encoded earlier and then put onto my phone actually looked really, really, really good. So, and then I was actually just checking out the other devices and so forth and what you can do with it. But a lot of people now obviously like to watch things on the go while they're at work, while they're, you know, on break or whatever they're doing. Everything is, a lot of the times they're on the go. But it also has the options of, you know, doing it through YouTube. And then you have the options of also converting it, the file, strictly to an audio format as well, instead of just doing the video, which is pretty cool. So I really like how they set everything up. It's very simple. It'll show you what your profiles that you've used already, general profiles, and then the DVD backup, which is really cool. So I could actually clone this entire DVD to an ISO image, and an ISO image is one file. It's similar to a zip, but it's one file with everything that's on the DVD or whatever you want from the DVD, as far as this is concerned, in one, what they call an image or an ISO file. And then from that ISO file, you can use programs like this to bring everything from that ISO file up and then go from there. So the one thing that I really wanted to show you, which was cool, which I do like, I really do like the mobile device support and how specific they really, really got on this as well. And for instance, for the Apple device, it's, if you just go to the Apple device, it's like to the iPhone video, and then it even has from the iPhone 6 all the way down to the iPhone 3, which is really, really cool. And then it also gives you the options if you want to use. So it even tells you if you don't know anything about, you know, codecs and all that kind of stuff, you know, what's recommended for your device and so forth. And long story short, MPEG-4 has been the standard for a long time. The H.264 is basically becoming the new standard, but MPEG and the H.264, when you're looking at it on a smaller device, there's not a huge difference of quality. I mean, it's really not noticeable. And the AAC, so that's what the MPEG-4 is the video, and then the AAC encoder is the audio encoder. So, and like I said, what I did earlier, I encoded it, and what's really good is that these encode fast. This is Wedding Crashers is a 2-hour long movie. It's almost exactly 2 hours, including the credits. And it encoded, even on the high quality where it says slow, actually encoded very quickly. And then on the low quality, it encoded in, for me, running a 32-bit operating system with 4 gigs of RAM, it might have taken 10 minutes tops to encode a 2-hour video, which was really, really cool. So if you want to get specific with the device you have, you can do that and then go from there. For me, using what I have for my smartphone is an Android, so I would go to Android Mobile, and since it's actually not on my Android device, not on here, I just went to General Mobile Video and actually just picked the first one, and I tested them both out at the high quality and the low quality, and I'll actually show you. So what you would do from there, you pick which one you want. If you really want the high quality, go for it. If your screen, you know, like mine, is not that big, I forget the actual dimensions of this phone, but it's your very typical smartphone. but we'll still play HD videos and all that good stuff and high quality videos. So for the general, if your exact device is not listed here, you know, if you go in here and has, you know, all the different device, all the different kinds of phones that are out and so forth, and they have tons of them that are available as well. It just so happens that, you know, that mine is not on there. So they have all the Samsung Galaxies all the way down to the Galaxy 2, and all the way down to the, you know, the Samsung, whatchamacallit, the Samsung W999, excuse me. But so these are all the outputs that you can do. But just for, and it's all very updated, which is really, really nice. Obviously, you're not going to get every single phone in the entire world, but everything as far as MP4 goes is very universal. And so what I would do is, screw it, you know, we can do high quality, we can do, but like I said, if your phone, as long as you don't have the Note or something like the Mega or something huge, you know, the quality difference is really not that big. So if you're just going with a regular phone like this, that's not too big, it's not a tablet, then I would go with the lower quality because it's quicker. But either way, it's a really quick encoding process, and then you can just bring that encoded file directly over to your phone or to your tablet or whatnot. So from here, like I said, you would pick your device, but I'm gonna go back real quick because you can do, just to show you, you can do to, like I showed you, the iPhone, you can do to the iPad and all the different kinds of the iPads, you know, going back to, you know, you have the iPad mini 2 and just the regular iPad mini as well. And all these, it's just incredible that they have all these different, you know, the resolutions that are supported for each one and what's recommended. So you can do it to the iPad, you can do it to the iPod, you can do it to Apple TV video, to iTunes video, you know, to everything here. It's really, really, it's very simple too. So it's just, if, like I said, if you know nothing about this, you just go right to it, but, and then just encode from there. So back to this, Android, I'm doing Android Mobile for myself. I would go to general mobile video, and for me, I just picked the first one, which worked perfectly fine. They have some other specific ones here as well, but I'm still going to use just this top one, the general one, and I'm just going to do low quality. I would hit OK, and it has me ready. And basically, the safe mode option, you really, I didn't have any problems. There was something that popped up at the end after it finished and said this, you know, may not have converted correctly, and it actually did. So it was just something with the program just trying to, you know, be safe and just say, hey, just so you know, there may have been, but I haven't had a problem, and I've encoded, you know, six, you know, maybe up to 10 videos today. So now I just leave that off. I do check off the use high quality engine. I leave the deinterlacing alone, and then you can actually, with your CPU, you have cores inside the CPU. You can decide how many cores you want to use to run the encoding process. Obviously, the more cores you use, the faster it's going to be, but the more energy that's going to go into just encoding, and it's going to kind of, you know, not really pay attention to a lot of the other stuff that you're doing. Most of the energy of the computer is going to go to encoding this movie. So I have Wedding Crashers up. I have the main title. It shows you right here, 0 to 2 hours and 8 minutes long with a 16:9 ratio. And the subtitles I have disabled. And if I really want to, I can add the subtitles as well. And I can also add the other titles if I really want to. It gives you a pop-up that says, you know, this isn't the main one, and, you know, there's really, unless you really want it, there's not a huge point in having it. So if you scroll down, you'll probably see other titles that are maybe like bonus features and things like that, and if you really want them, you can check everything off. But if you really just want the actual movie itself, just to watch the actual movie itself, you would just leave the first title checked off, and you would just hit run, and then it would encode from there, and that's it, and it would encode to a .mp4, and then you have the option of opening the folder and where it's going to when it's done, or you have the option of shutting down the computer so you can leave, and this will continually go down, like it said, an hour, and then it says, you know, 55, and then 45, and then 42, 40, you know, 39, and it'll continually go down very rapidly. I don't have, the only thing that's running is the screen recording program that I'm using, which may slow that, which would maybe slow this down a little bit. But I would say if I was not running the screen recording program, this would even shoot down even, you know, an extra couple of minutes a lot quicker. So it's definitely the fastest one I've come across. So, but I'm just going to stop this. It'll put it to your whatever output folder you want, which is actually right here. I'm sorry, it is up there, but it shows you down here where the destination folder is going. So if I want, I can choose. What I was doing earlier is I was just putting it into a different folder, I think, which was just that was my folder. So yep, and I would let that go to there, and it came up as the MP4, and I could watch it on the Windows 7 operating system. And then from there, with the Android, you know, I just plugged in the Android and then use File Manager to drag over, or use Explorer to just drag that file into my videos folder on here. And I will actually show you how it came out, because it actually looks really good. This is the low quality version, and it actually looks really, really good for the low quality version. Hopefully you can see it relatively well.
Red Moon Dog 7-Eleven, 42-13.
So, that's it right there. And that's on the Moto G. And that is the low quality version.
I got you.
No, you didn't.
And
you're,
you can
cheating.
You're cheating.
Barely tell. You can barely tell the very subtleties and the lower quality on a typical regular phone size like this, but there's absolutely no lag in it. The buffer is perfect. The sound comes out beautifully, and the total size of this, of that file for a 2-hour video, I believe it was definitely under a gig, and I believe it came out to around 500 to 600 megabytes for a 2 hours and 8 minute long movie, which is pretty good. And now phones have the capability of handling, you know, almost not to the point of a computer yet, but can hold a lot of space. So that came out really well. I was really impressed with that. And then the other thing that you can do with this, so what I'm gonna do, we're gonna close this out again. We're gonna open her up, and we're gonna do the Wedding Crashers again. But this time, what we're gonna do, as it's loading the Wedding Crashers, what's cool is you can also make backups of your ISO image as well, which I really, really do like. And that would be, where am I going? DVD backup. And we could do clone DVD. So the full DVD clone backup. All you have to do is, this will turn this entire DVD into one ISO image. And then from that image, you can use this software, or you can use other software to burn that one image, and it'll come up just as that regular Wedding Crashers DVD did as well. And you just run it from there, and it'll come up as an ISO. And the same thing with the ISO, it's super quick. Like it does it so quickly and efficiently, which is really nice, and it's definitely got a lot of points in my book for that as well. And I'm not running it all the way through, and the time will significantly go down. The encoding process is extremely quick. I don't know how the hell they did that, but they did a fantastic job with it. I haven't played with the safe mode. I've been using the high quality engine. I've been leaving the interlacing alone. You can preview the video in here, which is nice, and actually take some pretty cool screenshots. So I could just take the screenshot of this right now, and then I believe I have it set to here. Or no, I don't. Where am I going? Where the heck do I have it going? So, come on. Destination folder. I took an image earlier, and this was the image that I took earlier, and from the actual program, from MacX DVD Ripper, and it came out absolutely spectacular. The resolution was absolutely spectacular. And let me just make sure that I have the output. I want to have the output on as the same as that guy as well. So let's just copy this and then do the snapshot. Or maybe I can't do that. I have to actually go to it. So let me go to that real quick. Go to new folder 2. Or I'm sorry, not new folder 2, MacX DVD. Select folder. Done. Okay. Disk. Wedding Crashers. And then we're going to... And it loads everything really quick as well. And it's loading everything while I know in the background that my screen recording program is using probably about 200,000 K of my memory. And so I'm just going to pick anything. I'm just going to go, we'll say, Sony device. And then you could even go to the PSP or the PS4. Or, you know, you can even do it to an Xbox as well, which is really cool. Or if you want to do it to Zoom video and all that good stuff. So it's really, it has a high compatibility with it, which is really nice. But so let's just go back to this. Doesn't matter. We're just going to do high quality. We're going to go to that. We're going to play it. We're just going to scroll around. And then there's a lot of good parts in this movie. And so I'm just going to take a snapshot, and I think it should pop up in here. So there it is. There's our snapshot that we just took. And it comes out really well for viewing it at 100%. So, and then this was actually what I did earlier was I tested the ISO process, where I actually backed up the disk, made it an ISO, and then was able to actually recover that ISO with this. So when I would click this, I went to the ISO, and I believe this one I did not. I believe I deleted the actual full one. I think I canceled this one through it. Yeah, so this one I actually canceled through it. But I did it earlier and opened it up, and it came right up, and I was able to export it. So even if you have an ISO image already on your... So this is not a burner. This is just a ripper. So this is just to take the videos off of the disk, or get the videos from an ISO image, and then put it to almost unlimited amount of the mobile phones and the different kinds of products that are out there, as far as Windows and Sony and Mac and all that. So it can go to all these different devices, and that's basically what this is for. It's to get you to have the precise resolution and quality for the exact specs of the phone that you're using, so you have no trouble whatsoever. So once you have it going to your output folder, you can just bring it to whatever device you're using. So whether it be by directly plugging in here, whether it be by putting it on a USB and then plugging it into something else, that video format will play precisely for the device that you encoded it for, and it will not take long at all. So my suggestion is to just run MacX by itself, MacX DVD Ripper by itself, and let it go through. It'll go really quick, and then you can just go, boom, right to your device. You know, just load it right onto your device and watch it on your device whenever you want. So if you don't feel like, you know, if, like I said, wherever you're at, you can watch the video wherever you're at, which is, like I said, what everybody does today. This is the newest version. There aren't any updates so far, as far as today. And I'm trying to think of the other. This is just the folder that everything went to today. And so I did a couple different tests on. I did them all MP4, and they all came out. So even just in playing it on Windows, and this was actually, like I said, this one I believe was meant for the Android, and it still looks pretty good. And I'm just trying to remember what the file size is. So that one was 664 megabytes. This was, they're all 664. Okay. It was just 664. The two gigabyte one was the higher quality one. So that was the one, if I really wanted to, is what I would put on to something that was, if I really didn't want to see any lowering of the resolution and just making sure it was nice and clear. But like I said, with a standard phone, a standard pocket phone, not something like the Note or the Mega or, you know, or an iPad or anything like that, the lower quality works great. And I'm sure the lower quality would look perfectly fine on something like a tablet as well. But it's totally up to the individual on what they feel they want. And I know everybody wants high quality, but if you have the space to do it, go for it. It'll take a little bit longer, but it's still really quick as far as encoding process. So it's definitely the quickest encoding process I have seen in a program, and that's definitely the truth. So I can't BS about that. But other than that, it's a very self-explanatory, very user-friendly interface. You don't need to be a brain surgeon to use this. It is super easy to use. I know there are tons and tons and tons of products and software out there that do what this software does as far as, you know, ripping and encoding and all that. I have just yet to see one that has encoded at this speed that this that the MacX DVD ripper does. And I've yet to see one that has that complete list of devices that the MacX DVD ripper also offers. And so as far as that, is it worth, I know they would say the original price is $50 and they have it on sale for the original price is $60. They have it on sale for $40. Is it worth $40 if you're going to use it on a continuous basis? Then I would say yes, absolutely. If it's just something that you need from time to time, just try the free trial, see if you like it. But if it's something that, if you do watch a lot of movies and if you do want to back up DVDs and you do want to have a really good encoding software, so even if you just have files that you can put to ISO and then you want to encode them to that, if you have video files and you put them to an ISO and you want to encode them, you can go all around, you know, you can go all around the internet and search for all these free ones and so forth, but this is the complete package as far as ripping. It is pretty much strictly for ripping DVDs and encoding the files from the DVDs, but it does have that ISO option as well, where as long as you have those video files within an ISO on your computer or on your Mac, you can bring it from that ISO and encode it to the device that you want as well. So at $40, if you're going to use it consistently, I would say absolutely worth it. It's really up to the individual, but it's definitely something that as far I feel as though I would definitely use, you know, on a regular basis, just because if I'm on the go and I'd like to share things with with different people and so forth, either when I'm working or when I'm out and so forth, and there's times where I don't want to fill up my phone with all this space, and I like that it has that option of putting it at the lower quality, and it still looks fantastic on the Moto, on my phone, which is the Moto G. So, but totally up to the user. So try the free trial download and go from there. Like I said, if you have Windows, click on the Windows version, and you can do either or. You can do the buy or download the free trial, and you'll see how simplistic it is and how user-friendly the entire interface is, and just the amount of options that you have as far as devices. So instead of going from, you know, this program or this website to this website and trying to find, you know, the exact format and the right resolution and the right quality and all that, the MacX DVD Ripper Pro has everything in one package for that DVD ripping option and for pulling files from an ISO to encode to a specific device. So that is my review about the the Digiarty MacX DVD Ripper Pro. Like I said, they do not have many programs that are available for Windows, but as far as this one, this is the best one I've seen for Windows. I do feel as though at that sale price, that $40 is reasonable. There would still be maybe a little bit of hesitancy to spending that unless you were using it consistently. So if it was, like, for instance, like, people will throw out a couple $100 for something like Microsoft Office, you know, and they might not do the same for things that they, for other software that they feel as though they're not going to use as much. So, but if this is a program that you feel that, hey, you know what, I could definitely use this, I definitely want to back up my DVDs, I definitely want to put them to, I definitely want these files to be supported on the exact devices that I have, then I would say absolutely 100%. Just buy it, be done with it. $40, it's nothing, goodbye. And it seems that they do continually update all of their software, and you would continually get the updates to the software. So, and the MacX DVD Ripper Pro, like I said, is for Mac and is for Windows. I primarily use Windows. So if you have Windows, this is definitely the all-inclusive package. And if you have Mac, this is the all-inclusive package as well. And I know in here as well, it wasn't just English as well. There was definitely a couple other languages that I did see. So you got 11 different languages as of this moment right now. So English, Japanese, German, all that good stuff. So that's my review. I'm sticking to it. Without a doubt, regardless of the price, it's definitely the best DVD ripping software out there. And it's the best, it's the quickest, it's the most efficient, it's the most supported, and overall, I'm gonna have to give it, as far as a DVD ripping software, a 10 out of 10. I have to, because it was so easy to navigate, and just to see all the supported devices that it had embedded within that program, and it was just a real no BS, no hassle program, extremely quick, no crashing or anything like that, and it seemed as though this was just made by magic somehow. So definitely worth a shot, the MacX DVD Ripper Pro for Windows. And like I said, that's my review. I'm sticking to it. I hope you enjoyed. Please subscribe and let me know what you think. Try it out. Leave me a comment. And I will see you guys next time. Later.